Hey guys, what's up? We're having a look at this, the Mazda 3 with all-wheel drive. And when I heard that the Mazda 3 was available with all-wheel drive, I had to drive it. And thankfully, it is winter here. But if you're a fan of the channel and you've looked through the back catalog of reviews, you note that there is nothing from Mazda except for MX-5s. Of course, the highlight was the Flying Miata and DV8, but that's another story altogether.
Before we get too far into this episode, I have to tell you something. Recently, I stopped by Mazda's R&D center in Irvine, California, and spoke with Ken Saward, Director of Automotive Design. And in this episode, Ken's got the final word on why the design of this Mazda 3 is so impressive. And it's not what you think, so stick around until the end of the episode for that.
If you know anything about the Mazda 3's powertrain, it's pretty much what you'd expect with the all-wheel drive system, and we'll get into that. But of course, in this part of the world, all you can get is the 6-speed automatic transmission with the all-wheel drive. And that's unfortunate because I think this would be a heck of a lot of fun with a manual. But as we know, not a lot of people buy manual transmissions. And, you know, I understand that this 6-speed automatic is not bad. It's not absolutely perfect, but there is manual control and there is a sport mode which just changed throttle mapping and the shift algorithm, and that works fine. And it probably should be the default mode, but we know that why that's not a why that's not going to happen. But certainly in sport mode with the different throttle map and the different shift algorithm, it is a little more responsive, and I certainly enjoy it a little more.
What's going on mechanically under here? Powering this Mazda 3 is what they call their Sky Active G naturally aspirated 2.5 liter four cylinder. 186 horsepower at 6,000 RPM and 186 pounds of torque at 4,000 RPM. Those power and torque curves are exactly what you'd expect for an engine like this. Oh, and it takes regular fuel, premium not required, thankfully. Power goes through a 6-speed automatic, as I mentioned, and the all-wheel drive system is constantly monitoring what's going on with the car, not just for slip, but various systems in order to send the right amount of torque to the rear axle. For me, it's seamless, and I have zero complaints, except that I didn't have enough snow to play in during this test.
There is plenty to love about this Mazda 3, and pardon me for getting all excited about it. I generally don't drive a lot of compact cars, but I have driven, let's see, Civics, Corollas, and maybe Elantra in the last little while, and the styling and the interior design and finish of this Mazda 3 beats all of them. It is fantastically well designed, and this is surprising for such a small company to turn out something so good, but you know, they have to do that. Mazda has to make a very attractive compact to compete in the segment. But this, really, the design and the exterior design, the interior design and the interior finishes just knock this out of the park. It is very premium. There are a lot of premium elements here. Fit and finish is excellent, and the way everything feels is exceptionally premium as well. And I have to give credit to Mazda for pulling this off. I mean, everything inside is absolutely top notch. Let's see how the ABS works here. Oh, so good. What I love about Mazda as a company is that they build cars for drivers because they're drivers. And you can really tell with the seating position like this, starting with the steering wheel, it's the right shape, it's the right size, it's there's enough adjustment in the steering column. Then with the seat, it goes low enough to the floor, the seat is exceptionally supportive, and you're set up perfectly with that simple driver interface. And it reminds me of BMW in the good old days. It's just an absolutely perfectly simple cockpit, and Mazda has done a fantastic job here. The gauges are clear, very straightforward. There are a couple of dials, and as you can see, there's a digital portion of the cluster in the middle, and that works great. The infotainment system has been updated as well and does include finally Apple CarPlay, but the rest of it is a bit clunky. The controller is very similar to some other manufacturers, BMW, and the rest of the interface is a little bit clunky. It's a little bit difficult to navigate through that system, but you do eventually get used to it. And of course, if you're an iPhone user like me, you just throw on Apple CarPlay and you're very happy there as well. The rest of the secondary controls are exceptionally well laid out. The HVAC system, very simple, very straightforward, and it the display is clear. The buttons feel like they belong in a high-end car, and as well, a lot of these buttons, like the steering wheel buttons for the adaptive cruise control and the secondary audio controls, they just feel very premium, as do the window switches and the door lock switch. And of course, that's encased in this speaker grille with the Bose sound system, so it does add a very premium look and feel. And in a lot of ways, this interior, I hate to say it, but punches above its weight. It is very, very finely finished and beautifully designed. I can't say enough about this interior, except one thing. And that is the way that this car is designed and the way the driver is placed. You do sit a little closer to the B pillar than you'd like. And of course, if you're like me, you don't shoulder check, and this car does have blind spot warning and all that sort of thing. But I adjust the mirrors outboard so that I can see all around the car, and that's not a problem. The problem, however, is if you're trying to use your peripheral vision, those last few degrees of your peripheral vision are blocked by this B pillar, and it's a little annoying, but it's not too bad to live with, because again, the car does come with a very good blind spot warning system, and that makes it a little more tolerable, but this drives me nuts. I'm going to tell you a little story. A couple of days ago, one of my pals came to visit and we went out to dinner. And generally, I have a rule. If I've got a test car, I want to experience that with more people. But I already knew at that point that three of us were not going to fit in this car. And whoever was going to sit in the back seat was going to be compromised. The interior is quite small, particularly in comparison to Civic, for example. Might be something I'm willing to compromise on for me, but I don't have to worry about children riding in the back seat, let alone adults. I will say, however, that I do fit behind myself and it's reasonably comfortable for me, but this interior is perhaps where the Mazda 3 suffers in relation to the competition. And it's that second row that is tiny, and that's just how it goes. I'd like to see that second row a little bit bigger, but you know that's not gonna happen with the overall design of the car. In terms of interior storage, there is plenty of room. There's lots of room under the hatch. I've got a bunch of stuff in there right now, no problem loading and unloading. And there's lots of cargo carrying capacity, and the rear seats fold down exceptionally easy as well. In addition to the Mazda 3's beautiful design, where this car shines is really with its dynamics, and you can tell it was engineered and developed by drivers. Steering, handling, braking, I give it top marks in the segment, especially the brake pedal. If you're a fan of the channel, you know I love a good brake pedal, and this thing has almost telepathic feel down to the contact patch. I absolutely love this brake pedal, and they've done a fantastic job. Steering, similarly, just as precise and direct. I absolutely love the steering response. And there's something that we do need to talk about, which is Mazda's G vectoring control. They're calling it GVC, and it's one of the things they do want to tell you about this that differentiates the Mazda 3 and a lot of the Mazda product from its competition. And it's not what you think it is. G vectoring control is not a limited slip diff, it's not traction control, it's not stability control. Let me explain this so you really understand. And it's the kind of thing that only a Japanese company would think of and develop and put on their production cars.
GVC starts with the understanding that Mazda's philosophy is all about driving pleasure first and foremost. And what it does is exactly what the experienced driver does in order to get optimum bite out of the tires before you enter a turn. At the exact moment the driver turns the wheel, the GVC system very subtly reduces engine torque by a very small amount, which then transfers some weight to the front tires, and that gives them more bite than if they were loaded normally. It's something that's imperceptible to the driver and passengers, and it's something that only a company like Mazda would do. For me, this Mazda 3 turns into a corner the way I want it to every time, and Mazda says it reduces driver and passenger fatigue over long distances. The cool factor is very high with this Mazda 3.
I think you can tell that I'm very impressed with this Mazda 3, and it's immediately nailed itself to the top of the list of compact cars I'm going to recommend to people who ask about compacts. This thing is absolutely fantastic in every way, save for those couple of compromises that I mentioned, and I'm very impressed with this in so many ways. If you're looking at a compact, you need to look at this Mazda 3. It is absolutely fantastic. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this Mazda 3 with all-wheel drive. Hope you liked this piece, and if you did, you know what to do. You're not new to YouTube, and if you want to help us out, hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of cool stuff there, and that'll save you a trip to the mall if you buy some stuff at our merch store, and we'd really appreciate it, and that's going to keep us on YouTube. Anyway, thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time.
I'm Ken Saward, Director of Automotive Design for Mazda R&D in Irvine, California, and this is the final word. For us, the Mazda 3 is all about moving this product into the premium segment. We've improved the ride quality, the performance, the handling, the interior craftsmanship, and from an exterior standpoint, we've really worked hard to get the design to be a dramatic, beautiful, iconic statement from Mazda. When looking at the Mazda 3, you'll notice the beautiful, voluptuous surfaces. One of the ways we create these surfaces is by the way we put the paint on the final surface. We develop them by hand with craftsmen, Takumi modelers, and chief designers, but we also put a lot of effort into the color of the car and how the paint is laid on the car. We use a very unique process for our Sol Red Crystal and our Machine Gray in laying actually four layers of paint over the surface, which really gives the paint a lot of depth, gives it a lot of high highlights and a lot of dark, deep shadows, which enhances the forms. That's how we're able to give the car a very premium look and very voluptuous, beautiful surfaces.